Good afternoon, I'm Peter Overton. In less than a minute, the Reserve Bank will hand down its monthly decision on interest rates with a seventh consecutive hike, all but confirmed. It's a searing spotlight on this decision. Chris Kohler, our finance reporter, is with me. Chris, what do you think we'll see?
Well, Pete, almost everyone is expecting another interest rate hike today, as you said. It's really just about how much. Most major economists are predicting another 0.25% hike, which is what we saw last month. But there is Westpac. It's last week changed their opinion and said that we'll see another 0.5% today, which would really throw households into a real problem because they thought that things were slowing down. And then here we would go with another big rate hike. Either way, it's going to be hurting households.
0.25, Chris, 0.25.
Another 0.25%. So the interest rate, the official Australian cash rate goes from 2.6 to 2.85%. That is from the Reserve Bank today. We're talking about a seventh consecutive interest rate hike. As you can see there, the new rate now 2.85%. Pete, this is going to be hurting households all over the country, no doubt about it.
Indeed. So they didn't go the way Westpac predicted, 0.5%, because we had the inflation figures at big numbers only a week or so back. So they're still doing it incrementally, 0.25%. Of course, we want to know what it's going to look like now for our mortgage repayments. Chris, we do have a graphic based on this 0.25% increase in the official cash rate. Take us through it.
Yeah, so this is really depends on how much you owe is how much this is going to hurt you. If you have $500,000 in debt, today's interest rate hike is likely to add another $74 a month onto your repayments. And combined hikes since May, we're talking about $760 extra dollars per month. $750,000, those numbers become $112 extra dollars per month and well over $1,000 in combined rate hike repayments. And if you're on $1 million in terms of your home loan, we're talking about almost $150 extra dollars a month and $1,500 extra dollars in combined interest rate hikes. Now, unfortunately, at the same time as this is going on, we know that wages just are not keeping pace at all, Pete. So homeowners are having to find this money elsewhere in their budget. And this is very distressing as we head towards Christmas. People are unsure really about how it's going to look early next year either. But certainly this is not predicted to be the last interest rate hike we see. We know that Commonwealth Bank are expecting at least one more. But we've got Westpac and ANZ, which expect the cash rate to continue rising until it hits 3.6%. So unfortunately, households are in the thick of it right now, and a lot of them will be scratching their heads and saying, well, where is this extra money going to be coming from?
Chris, just before we go, what is a good interest rate in the marketplace now based on this result today?
Yeah, well, the average variable interest rate before this decision was 5.4%. So you can add that up and it becomes 5.61%. That is what most homeowners will be paying right now if they haven't refinanced lately. A good rate, you'd be expecting to see anywhere below 4.5% would be considered a good interest rate right now. So you can still refinance and there's a lot of competition for home loans out there, and anything less than 4.5% would be considered a pretty good rate right now, Pete.
And what we've got to look out for is when those variable rates come off next year and so on, people who'd locked in, that's when the pain is really going to hit them. It really is. Chris, thanks so
Absolutely.
Much.